and our aim during 2025 is to identify which patients respond and benefit from our therapy, how we should deliver our therapy, and also how we immunize our patients to the therapy. All of these parameters are important to help us design the next phase of development.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Scancell CEO Phillip L’Huillier. Phil, very good to speak with you. You've announced today a partnership with the NHS Cancer Vaccine Launchpad that's to fast-track patients into the SCOPE study. What's the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad, and what does this collaboration mean for Scancell?
Hello, Stephen, and thank you for taking the time to talk with me about Scancell and our new partnership with the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad. The first thing I would actually say is this is a very positive endorsement for Scancell and for the medicines that we are developing. iSCIB1+, our experimental medicine being developed under the SCOPE study, is showing long-term immune control in tumors, which is, as we call it, the duration of response and the progression-free survival. This is what patients need when they first come onto therapy, and they also want a therapy that is safe. Pleasingly, we're seeing that with our iSCIB1+ vaccine. This partnership with the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad, Peter Johnson and his team, who are world leaders in accessing patients for clinical studies like this, will provide much faster access for patients in the United Kingdom to our experimental therapy. The partnership actually allows hospitals to access the therapy more quickly and join the SCOPE study more quickly, offering this advanced melanoma patients access to the iSCIB1+ therapy. Finally, perhaps just to add, isn't it fantastic to see a medicine being developed by Scancell, a highly innovative United Kingdom company, being available first, really, to patients in the United Kingdom through the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad with the NHS? We are the first U.K. company to partner with the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad, and our iSCIB1+ product is the first cancer vaccine, a DNA vaccine available to patients.
Phil, can you tell me more about your cancer vaccines and how we should assess the potential benefits to patients?
Yes, so Scancell develops immunotherapies as a mission for a cancer-free survival. Our lead product, iSCIB1+, being tested under the SCOPE study and now partnered with the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad, is a DNA vaccine that generates a long-term immune benefit to the patient and attacks the tumors. We deliver it on top of standard of care, which is a checkpoint therapy in the United Kingdom. What it does is create high avidity T cells, just to get technical, that helps create this long-term immune control. It works synergistically with the existing therapies, the checkpoint therapies, and brings benefit on top of the checkpoint therapies. As you may know, Stephen, sadly, although checkpoint therapies work really well in melanoma, they actually only bring benefit to about half the patients, and then many of those patients that respond, the response is very short-lived. By adding iSCIB1+ on top of standard of care, what we're doing is lengthening the duration of that response, but also bringing benefit to many more patients.
When do you expect to have full data from the SCOPE study? What are the next steps in bringing the drug to patients?
I think the first thing to say is we set out some timelines earlier in the year of when we would have data readouts, and we're very focused on meeting those timelines. In the middle of 2025, we will have data coming out of cohort one, our first-generation vaccine, SCIB1, but also cohort three, the second-generation product, the iSCIB1+ cohort. The fourth cohort that we're initiating right now with the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad, we will see data emerge from this cohort really at the end of the year, end of 2025. Our aim during 2025 is to identify which patients respond and benefit from our therapy, how we should deliver our therapy, and also how we immunize our patients to the therapy. And all of these parameters are important to help us design the next phase of development, which we're aiming and planning to kick off in the second half of 2026, either in partnership or alone.
What are the next major milestones or inflection points that investors should be watching out for, Phil?
Well, Stephen, I think it's those ones I just mentioned for the lead product, the iSCIP1 Plus product, the readout of the initial cohorts in the middle of 25, and then the fourth cohort later in 2025. But perhaps I can add on top of the lead product, we have also the second product in the pipeline, the Modi-1 vaccine. That's a peptide vaccine, unlike our DNA vaccine, that targets post-translational modifications, and it's applicable to a broader set of tumor types. So really a very innovative product. That's in clinical development in phase two in multiple tumor types now. And also on top of our iSCIP1 Plus readouts, we'll have readouts from the Modi-1 study, the Modify study, in the second half of 2025. Yeah. And then perhaps just to add there, Stephen, we also have an antibody portfolio from the GlyMab platform, and I'm determined to be able to apply more resource to develop in-house our antibodies in the portfolio. The end of last year, we completed a second partnership with Genmab, which is real in industry validation of what we're doing in our antibody portfolio. But to build greater value for shareholders, I'm determined to see us invest more in our lead program, SC134, targeting small cell lung cancer, as we go through 2025 and into 2026, so that we can take forward our antibody ourselves also.
As the new CEO, where are you putting your focus, Phil?
I think the first thing that I would say, Stephen, is building robust plans, and then executing these plans according to the timelines that we've set out. And that's what we're doing. I can say that, for example, we set out that we would fully recruit the third cohort in the SCOPE study. And indeed, we have done that according to the timelines we set out. And then secondly, pursuing the right sort of strategic partnerships and business development opportunities. I often say it takes a village to develop a medicine like we're medicines like we're working on. And so making sure we've got partners, as we've just announced with the Cancer Vaccine Launchpad, and business development relationships going forward to help us develop our medicines to registration and to patients is important. So that's been quite a focus of my effort and will be going forward. And then finally, building the organization ready for the next phase of development, executing on what we're doing. And I'm fully committed to delivering the portfolio that Scancell is developing as we promised on the timelines that we've set out. And this partnership is an illustration of how we can strengthen our efforts to move forward the medicines that we're developing.
I hope you'll keep us posted on progress with that. Phil, thank you very much for taking the time to speak with us today.